This is awesome. Hey guys, welcome back to Epic Marble Mania. Today we are doing a how to build a loop-de-loop for marbles using Weetabix cardboard, Oreo double stuff, loo roll, PVA glue, a knife, and some other tools, and of course, some marbles. Let's get going. So we've gone for a quick switcheroo, you know, because we found that this Coco Pops box is actually slightly larger than our Weetabix box. So we just need to make sure that we've got enough room to have a whole loop. We didn't think that the height of that Weetabix box would just... It might be just too short to, you know, get us our entire loop. So we're cutting this up. This is going to be... We're just cutting this side off to be our base for our mini marble run. And then we're going to go and cut the other side up into a loop. So here we're cutting out the side of the box. This could be our loop, I'm not completely sure yet. But hopefully this is long enough, and otherwise we're just going to have to use the middle and hope. Although actually that looks like a pretty good loop there. That looks like just enough space. It'll be a bit thinner than that though. It's gonna need some walls on there. But that looks good. So the next step is to fold the sides of the cereal box. We're gonna make the sides as the walls of our loop so that the marble doesn't fall out mid-loop. And that obviously it could fall down if it doesn't have enough speed. Which is hopefully not gonna have to happen. But this is going to be the barriers on the side so that it can't fall out the sides, and it forces it to go around the loop. And then, yeah, I'm going to fold both sides, and then when we curl it up we're going to cut small notches in each one and then fold it over and glue them. So hopefully that'll work. Alright, let's do the other side now. As you see, it helps to use a ruler so that you can get a nice straight fold, just because otherwise it's going to be quite messy, and if the marble bounces around too much in the loop, then it's never going to make it all the way around. It's not even going to come close. So we've done quite well here. We've cut it completely, and after some marble tests, we don't think we're going to need to do that much gluing of every single individual little cut. We're going to glue the two bottom parts of the loop together down there, and we're probably going to need to make sure that it stays in a perfect circle with a couple small bits of cardboard going from the bottom to the top of the loop. But after a few marble tests, it only takes the marble hitting the cardboard at a perfect angle and maybe about 5 centimeters of drop for it to go all the way around without even dropping at all. So from about there, it should work. So hopefully we'll be able to get that on our base successfully. Let's keep going. Now we've put some of our PVA glue in there, and we're now holding it and waiting for it to set and hoping that we keep our good circle. So shouldn't take too long, but you never know with glue. You've got to be quite careful so it doesn't fall apart. So we have made our entrance ramp. That is going to come down. And hopefully it's got enough speed to come all the way around the loop. Now, if we put a test marble down, it just about makes it down. Now, obviously the loop isn't held, and once we've properly supported this and curved it, it will work much better. But so far, so good. Now, quick revealing secret. If you are the kind of person that gets bored all the time, it's quite useful to use mini clips. It can be really good for while the glue is drying, and really fun to play with afterwards as well. But they're quite effective, they hold the cardboard together, and as you can see, we've been using a lot of them. But yeah, so here we've added our long ramp. Obviously it's not been supported yet. And that's going to come up at quite a high angle about there. And we've also got this piece here glued in. So hopefully we can have our thing perfect so that it works every time without falling apart. And we also plan to have a small ramp at the end. So maybe have a little jump landing in our ending bucket of whatever sort. And hopefully that all goes well. So we have now decided that we are going to add a jump to the end of our loop. Then that's going to land in a small finishing box. So we have this, and it's not been cut to size yet, but we're currently gluing it on to the end of the loop. And then we'll use some clips and keep that steady. And then once we've fixed our ramp into place, we'll decide how far we can actually go with the jump and cut it to size. But yeah, so now we're just gonna let that sit for a bit. And then we're almost done with the actual building of the actual track. Next step is to glue in a triangular support for our ramp, which is roughly the width. Yeah, it's gonna be the height of the width of the cereal box. So we've gone, it's got a triangle with one piece of overlap, and we're actually using our ruler to help it keep shape and keep it quite solid. But yeah, we will now let that set and then see whether we can find our optimum height for ramp angle, I guess. So yeah. So we have decided that we're going to use a small little bendable tab at the top and some supports down at the bottom that will be bent and glued onto the base later, and the small little bendable tab will be glued onto there. And that'll be all for our support, but we need to decide where we're going to actually put it first. So now it was time to test. Now we've tested a couple marbles down here, and obviously it's best to get it as steep as possible. But if it gets too steep, then it hits the bottom with too much momentum and doesn't make it round. But we've found that a couple angles have worked very well, and roughly there works quite well and sometimes even makes it all the way off the end of our jump. So here goes with one marble. Again. As you can see, that works very well. So we have found the optimum position, we have glued it down and fixed a couple of tabs that were getting in the way using a very interesting slow-mo, which we'll show you next. But now the marbles have gone through with about a 99.9 recurring with a 1-in-1 success rate. So we're quite pleased with it, and now we're gonna get rid of part of this jump and add a small extra bit onto our base about here, and make a small bucket for them to land in. So for the final stage of this loop-de-loop marble run, we are going to have a small channel that after the jump, we're going to have a small half pipe that feeds into the channel and it rolls all the way back to the end and then stacks up per marble so that you can grab them and put them back in at the top of the jump. So we're gluing them together here. Hopefully that works too well. Not too. No comment. So hopefully that works well and the glue doesn't get in the way. And with a slight tilt, because we don't have much altitude left, we should be able to get that working. We've successfully glued in our end ramp. Now, hopefully we're gonna have that much cardboard left at the end. Obviously, it's not connected yet, just in case we need it. But we're on track for our single box. But we've got our loop, and now we've got a piece of cardboard. Oh, some more cardboard as well. But we're going to try and get a small V shape going into the end point. So if you've made it this far into the video, hopefully you've enjoyed it. But now it's time to show you the finished product. We have added a backboard and a ramp, and the final piece is just setting. And we've used the remaining cardboard to make a very nice billboard. Now, if you would. As you can see, there are obviously a couple of things that we can still do, but it's worked quite well so far. Only one out of those marbles fell, and that was because it was working too well. Thanks for watching, guys. Now, hopefully I would like to see you soon in the next video, but if you want to make sure that you get notified as soon as that video comes out, don't forget to subscribe to this video. And also, well done to Alexis for winning the competition from the previous video for getting the right answer. So, well done to her. And, well, yeah, thank you for watching, and see you next time.